Hey guys, welcome back to Creatnprocess. In this video, we'll be designing a business card from the basic rough idea to the final design for print. Then we'll jump to Photoshop and create out the template for that design. So let's begin the tutorial. So now we are in Photoshop. On the layer, you can see there are three layers. The top two layers are for the reference. So the first one is for the foreground perspective view, that's for the business card. And the second one is for the background image. So let's drag in our exported image from the folder. So here are the two images. Just click and drag it in there and drop. Enter. And the two images will be there. First of all, I'll just hide this one and work out with this. So to do the transformation, Control T and right click, distort, and just align with the perspective views. So next thing, I will duplicate this for multiple number of times to create that bundle of a visiting card. So let's select this and duplicate the layer. Now select the lower layer, convert this rasterized layer and select this. And let's fill this up with a different color. Let's fill this up with some blue color from here, but some little darker like that. Alt backspace, let's see. Okay, that's great. Now Control D, we got that. Just push it up a little bit, giving it some little depth here. You can see that. Let's see around. Okay, duplicate this one more time. This time we'll fill this up with dark blue from here, and let's see. Alt backspace, Control D, just drag it down, and yes, we got that nice effect. Now we'll do this, duplicate this for multiple number of times. So if you see, you can see there are some random effects here. So that's all. Now let's go further. Next thing we need to do here is let's align with the perspective. Right now, if we check it out, first of all, I'll just select all these and group this up. So select all these and Control G to group it up. Let's name it bundle, B-U-N-D-L-E bundle. Enter. Now you can see. So if you check it out, our perspective view is this way. We have drawn it for a reference, but this one, well, we need to adjust that. So to do that, we'll just select that. You can merge this layer, merge group, and this will convert it to one object. So now let's transform it. So Control T, then wrap, and let's reduce the opacity so that we can see that reference line. And now let's work it out. So first of all, I select this and bring in till here. So enter, and we have done the correction. Here, next thing, let's go to image, curve, and let's play around with the color. So let's select that red, increase the tone, select that green, let's play around with that, select the blue, let's play around with the blue color. So like that, green selected, and let's give some like that, red, let's play around with here, and click OK. So we got that nice color here now. Now we'll select this bundle image and we'll do some adjustments. Right now it has the same color, but in a perspective view we have two surfaces, so we need to adjust that. So I'll use the lasso tool and select this portion of the area. So with the click, just select this, click, 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 and click. Now we'll adjust the color. So selecting that, go to image, adjustments, go. And let's increase the color tone. So let's be like that. You can see now we got that variation in color, and click OK. In the same way, other portion was selected, and now if you check it out, it's looking great. We have got two variation in color. Now let's add up some shadows. let's add it up. So I'll just duplicate this one more and make it to multiply. So if you see, we have got very dark, so reduce the opacity to around 40 or 50. And now let's do some adjustments with the eraser tool. We'll just delete this out from the top portion and from here, this portion leaving for here. So let's delete this. So after that, let's create out a shadow. So to do that, let's add some drop shadow. So I'll just duplicate this one more. And on the top below one, double click on that and add a drop shadow effect. So click that drop shadow and let's do some adjustments. Let's reduce the distance first, then let's increase the size. Let's reduce the opacity for, and let's check it out. So increasing the distance and play around with the angle like that, reduce the size, blur size, reduce the distance, increase it. So okay, now if you check it out, that's great. Now let's draw some shadows. So with the lasso tool, we'll just draw some shadows. So here I just create out a layer and just draw out a shadow. So first of all, drawing out from click here, then going till here, then there and there, and just place it. So now I just fill this up with certain color. So let's choose the color like black, alt backspace, control D, go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and let's give some blur. Now let's reduce the opacity. So I'll go to opacity and let's give it around 25, enter. Now let's add few more like the sharp shadow. So with the lasso tool, we'll create few more. So now let's duplicate this for our second surface. So I just click this with the alt press, just click and drag it out, and I'll just align this with this. So control T and align this along with this. I'll just scale this up a little bit and that's great. Now go to layer and add a drop shadow effect. So I'll just select that drop shadow and let's check it out. Okay, let's reduce the distance and blurriness. You can increase the distance here like that and reduce the opacity and increase the blur effect, and you got that nice effect. Okay, that's great. So if you check it out, that's looking great. Now let's see our next layer. Where is that? Here it is. So I'll just bring this in, control T, and now let's snap it over that. So with the distort tool, I'll just bring it in. So you got that nice effect here. Now last thing, we need to add some gradient here on the top. It's looking like a flat, so we select this disk and duplicate it for one more time, and let's add some multiply color and reduce the opacity to around this 50, and let's convert this to rasterized layer. Now individually with the eraser tool, we select individual layer and let's delete out few stuff. So here we need lighter, and as we go further, it will be darker. So like that. So you got to see that. And the same way, select this eraser from lighter to darker. If you check it out, it's looking like that. So if you increase or decrease the opacity for there, you can see the changes here. So it's on your. So we'll just reduce this to around 45. That's great. So now if you check it out, it's looking great. Now let's add up some background color. Before that, I'll just select all these and deselecting the background and just place it around here like that. And now let's add the background. So image, I take out an image from here, and this is just a rough image. let's add some effects. I'll just use the brush tool B, and on top I'll just draw one layer and increase the brush, and let's choose it soft brush. Now change the color to white and click here and click there, and you got a nice flash of color. You can just place it around, and let's change it to screen or maybe overlay and reduce the opacity. So increase it, reduce the opacity to 50 maybe, and if you play around with this, you got this nice reflection here. You can see nice shadow, and it's great. We'll just group this up all. So selecting everything, Control G, and duplicate it one more. Now I'll just hide this original one and merge group, and we got one image. Now we'll do some adjustments here. So let's go to here and bring in curve. Let's do the overall adjustment. So let's do some adjustments. Now let's give some lens blur effect. So I'll use this tool, and using the ellipse tool with the from click here, and just draw the ellipse like this, and with the control and shift I, you can inverse the selection. Go to filter, select that layer first, go to filter, blur, lens blur, and here let's do some adjustments. So let's give this octagon or maybe any hexagon, and let's increase the value radius here. If you increase it, you can see the changes. So here you see, here we got some blur effect, and if I increase it more, then you can see here the blur effect comes still there. So let's give it around 8 and maybe a little bit lesser, 6, and click OK and Control D. So you got a nice lens blur effect here. Let's create our text. So I'll use the text type out print, print design, design, and let's Control T, scale it up and enter. Let's change the color to black. Now let's do some adjustments here. We can increase the shadow, so I'll just go there to the layer and check it out. Okay, this layer we can just increase it opacity here so that we can see a little more depth. You can see that, check it out, that's looking great. So finally we have designed this template using the design which you have created in Illustrator. And currently I'm working on the whole stationery package of this design, so it's going to take a little more time, but I'll keep you updated. If you're looking for more resources on print design, check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.